In this video, I will explain three places in lower extremity where nervous tissue impingement most likely to occur. So I will explain three places. Okay. First place is around hip joint and pelvis, which is about this area. What kind of nervous tissue is there? There's the biggest peripheral nerve in human body. This is sciatic nerve. Sciatic nerve that runs like this way. Then how the sciatic nerve gets impingement? The most common thing is this muscle. This is piriformis. Piriformis is one of hip muscles. Sciatic nerve shows up from beneath piriformis. So when your piriformis is very tight, there's chance that this muscle kind of tightened up sciatic nerve. Then what's gonna happen? There is numbness around posterior part of thigh, and related muscles are included. Then sciatic nerve bifurcates to two nerves, tibial nerve and common fibular nerve. Tibial nerve and common fibular nerve. Then these two nervous tissues can be aggravated as well, because this nerve sends nervous tissues to posterior part of leg. Okay? Then when this part is aggravated, that can affect both tibial nerve and common fibular nerve. Okay, so let's go to common fibular nerve next. This is lateral view of knee joint. Okay, this part is knee, this is lateral view. Okay, common fibular nerve is this one. Do you remember? Common fibular nerve is from sciatic nerve. Then, where is common fibular nerve damaged the most likely? That's this part. You see, this nerve kind of wraps around neck of fibula. Okay, this part is neck of fibula. Okay, then you don't see big muscles around this place. Okay, I will say that again. Common fibular nerve kind of wraps around neck of fibula, and there are not big muscles covering this place. That means this place is very shallow. This nerve runs shallow place, superficial place. And this nerve runs around bone. That means if there's strong impact around this area, there is chance that this nerve gets damaged or compressed against bone. What happens then? This nerve gets damaged. Common fibular nerve basically innervates anterior part and lateral part of lower leg. Anterior and lateral part of lower leg. Rest of the place is innervated by tibial nerve, like posterior part and deep part of lower leg. This part can be damaged from chronic use of the leg or physical trauma. The famous cause is you get leg kick here. You know, it's common in martial arts. Again, this place is very fragile. So when somebody got leg kick here, common fibular nerve has high chance to get damaged. Common fibular nerve here. Let's go to tibial nerve. Okay, this is number 3. This is medial view of ankle. Medial view. Yep. You are looking ankle from inside. This is tibial nerve. This nerve runs medial part of ankle and it goes to plantar surface of foot. So it kind of dives into deep part of plantar surface. This nerve runs medial part and it dives into plantar surface. Related tissue is this one. This is retinaculum, particularly flexor retinaculum. Flexor retinaculum, it's like a socks of ankle joint, or it's like a supporter of ankle joint. To keep these tissues in adequate position, if there's no retinaculum, these muscles and nervous tissues kind of pops out. But when this retinaculum gets tight, that can pinch nervous tissue. What's this nerve? This is tibial nerve, right? Tibial nerve. Where is this nerve going? This is going to plantar surface of foot. So these related muscles are affected, and maybe there's numbness on plantar surface of foot. There are other reasons to get tibial nerve is damaged, such as if there is fracture on inferior part of tibia. Let's say there's fracture here. Tibial nerve runs very close to tibia and ankle joint, right? So if there's fracture, this bony fracture can aggravate tibial nerve, say fracture. Plus, there are many muscles running parallel to tibial nerve. These muscles are like flexor hallucis longus, flexor digitorum longus, tibialis posterior. These muscles are important to maintain foot arch, and they are important for foot mechanics. So these muscles need to work all the time. But if there's fatigue, chronic use of these muscles, that can aggravate tibial nerve because they are very close each other. Okay, there are many factors that nervous tissue is aggravated, such as retinaculum, fracture, or too much use of muscle tissues. You can say the same thing for common fibular nerve. There is fibularis longus, fibularis brevis. They are close to common fibular nerve. Let's go to sciatic nerve. Maybe you use too much of piriformis, other related muscles, or maybe hamstrings. Too much use of muscles around this area can create impingement for sciatic nerve. So in this video, I explained three places in lower extremity where nervous tissue impingement most likely to occur. First place, around sciatic nerve. Second place is around common fibular nerve, it's around neck of fibula. Last place, last nerve is medial part of ankle, and this is tibial nerve. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.